All right, next we're going to build a basic script with static properties that we're going to return. So let's look at some code here. The first thing I want to point out again is this is our logging. So we did import logging, and so we can see this show up in the debug in the log file, and we'll take a look at that in a moment. Then at the bottom, we do the same thing at the end just to show the properties that were sent across. And here we are creating a map that maps between the internal name that we defined in the properties file. So connect M3SP department and description. Those are going to be mapped back to whatever is returned from our M3SP server for department and description as well. Again, things that come from the counteract, we have this params dictionary. So in this case, recall we had a dependency for the MAC address. So we're going to check to see if that MAC address is in params. If so, we're going to log that to the screen, and we'll go ahead and show what the MAC address was that was sent across. And then to get things back to the counteract or the Forescout, we define a couple dictionaries here, responsive properties. We set the property to the internal name on the counteract that we had defined in the properties file to some value, and we can do that for both of those. And then we include that in the response dictionary equal to the properties, and we send that back. Okay, switching back to our editor, you can see that I have included this script for you. It's in the 1-M3SP resolve Python. And what we're going to do now is we're going to build a distribution with this script in it. We'll upload it, and then we're going to run it and see what happens in the debug. All right, let's get ready to create a distribution. I'm going to move this to the trash. We'll leave our system comp, property comp, they're still good, and they're actually pointing to M3SP resolve. So let's do this, remove this. We'll take the one from with the one on dash on the front of it, and let's duplicate that just so we keep a copy and rename that properly. All right, now that we're ready to create our distribution, we can compress this, and we're ready to go. Let's flip over to our counteract. We'll have to remove the existing one, as always. And apply it. All right, let's bring our new distribution in. Looks like it was successful. We'll add our connection for Scout 123, for Scout 123. And we'll finish. Okay, we'll apply that. And let's test it to make sure it's working. And everything looks good. All right, let's see our script in action. So let's get our debugging going. I'm going to connect to my counteract. I'm going to get myself into the right directory. Here you can see we have Python logs. One of the things that you need to bear in mind is that we need to set the debug level on the actual counteract plugin, and then that will be reflected in the Python log as well. So I believe I have Yep, there's the command right there. So I'm going to set the debug level to 5, and it'll set it automatically for 7 days here. And now I should be able to simply watch the Python log. And see any of the messages that we're logging in our script in the debugs here. So let's do that. So we'll go back to the counteract. First thing we need to do is create a policy that looks for the properties that we've defined. So we'll do a custom policy. We'll name it something like M3SP. Let's look for the department. Our segment will just be the lab. And our condition is going to be M3SP department, any value. Okay, we'll finish. We will apply and save that. Now we go to our policies. And here you can see we have 5 devices that trigger the policy. Let's look at one of them. Let's look at our properties. And you can see indeed that we have a department and a description associated with that. All right, let's pick one of these. Let's do 17 here. We know what the MAC address is. Actually, let's set up our logging first so we can see what's going on. Here we have, I've logged into the counteract. And one thing that you do need to do is set the debug level on the plugin to 5. And that'll propagate over into the Python logs as well. Then we're gonna watch the Python log that we have here. So we're gonna tail minus F the Python server logs. And looks like we got some heartbeats going there. Okay, let's flip over to the counteract, pick one of these devices. We'll do a quick recheck. And we just wanna make sure that stuff is showing up in the logs. And sure enough, we're seeing stuff in the logs. Remember, we said logging.info, so that's the logging level. It is coming from our script, and you can see some of the text here. So starting MS3P script, and you can see resolving MAC address 17. If we look back at the code here, you can see we're saying resolve MAC address, and whatever the value of the params sub MAC was given to us.